नमस्ते, माय सेल्फ त्रिवेणी खुराना, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, फैकल्टी ऑफ फिजियोथेरेपी एंड डायग्नोस्टिक्स, जेविया, राजस्थान। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट आईएफटी। आईएफटी इज इंटरफेरेंशियल थेरेपी। द बेसिक प्रिंसिपल ऑफ इंटरफेरेंशियल थेरेपी इज टू यूटिलाइज द स्ट्रॉन्ग फिजियोलॉजिकल पोर्टेबल इफेक्ट्स ऑफ लो फ्रिक्वेंसी electrical stimulation of nerves without the associated painful and somewhat unpleasant side effects sometimes associated with low frequency stimulations. To produce low frequency effects at the sufficient intensity at depth, patient can experience considerable discomfort in the superficial tissue, that is skin. This is due to the impedance of the skin being inversely proportional to the frequency of the stimulation. In other words, the lower the stimulation frequency, the greater the impedance to the passage of the current, and so more discomfort is experienced as the current is pushed into the tissue against this barrier. The skin impedance at 50 Hz is approximately 3200, whilst at 4000 Hz it is reduced to approximately 40 degrees. The result of applying a higher frequency is that it will pass more easily through the skin, requiring less electrical energy input to reach the deeper tissues and giving rise to less discomfort. The effect of tissue stimulation with these medium frequency currents, or medium frequency in electromedical terms, which is usually considered to be 1 kHz to 100 kHz. It is unlikely to do nothing at all, but in terms of current practice, little is known of its physiological effects. It is not capable of direct stimulation of a nerve in the common context of such stimulation. Interferential therapy utilizes two of these medium frequency currents passed through the tissue simultaneously, where there are set up so that their paths cross and they literally interfere with each other. This interference gives rise to an interference, that is, beat frequency, which has the characteristics of low frequency stimulation. In effect, the interference mimics a low frequency stimulation. The exact frequency of the resultant beat frequency can be controlled by input frequencies. Example: one current was at 4000 Hz and its companion current at 13900 Hz, the resultant beat frequency would be at 100 Hz. Carried on a medium frequency, 3950 Hz amplitude modulated current. By careful manipulation of the input currents, it is possible to achieve any beat frequency that you might wish to use clinically. Modern machines usually offer frequency of 1 to 150 Hz, though some offer a choice of up to 250 Hz or more. To a greater extent, the therapist does not have to concern themselves with the input frequencies, but simply with the appropriate beat frequency, which is selected directly from the machine. Now, what is frequency sweep? Nerves will accommodate to a constant signal, and a sweep is often used to overcome this problem. Sweep is gradually changing frequency. The principle of using the sweep is that the machine is set to automatically vary the effective stimulation frequency using either preset or user set sweep ranges. The sweep range employed should be appropriate to the desired physiological effects. It has been repeatedly demonstrated that wide sweep ranges are ineffective in the clinical environment. Care need to be taken when setting the sweep on a machine in that with some devices the user sets the actual base and top frequencies, example 10 and 25 Hz. And with other machines, the user sets the base frequency and then how much needs to be added for the sweep, example 10 and 15 Hz. Sweep triangle, sweep rectangle and sweep trapezoidal patterns are. The pattern of sleep makes a significant difference to the stimulation received by patient. Most machines offer several sleep patterns, though there is a very limited evidence to justify some of these options. In the classic triangular sleep pattern, the machine gradually changes from the base to the top frequency, usually over a time period of 6 seconds, though some machines offer 1 or 3 second options. In the example, machine is set to sweep from 90 to 130 Hz, employing a triangle sweep pattern. All frequencies between the base and top frequencies are delivered in equal proportions. Other patterns of sweep can be produced on a machine. Example, rectangular or step sweep. This produces a very different stimulation pattern in that the base and the top frequencies are set, but the machine then switches between these two specific frequencies rather than gradually changing from one to other. There is a clear difference between, example, even though the same numbers are set, one will deliver a full range of stimulation frequency between the set frequency levels and other will switch from one frequency to the other. There are numerous other variations on this theme, and the trapezoidal sweep is effectively a combination of these two. Only the sweep frequency, sweep pattern for which evidence appears to exist is triangular sweep. Others are perfectly safe to use, but whether they are clinically effective or not remains. Now, what are the physiological effects and clinical application of IFT? It has been suggested that IFT works in a special way because it is interferential as opposed to normal stimulation. Evidence for this special effect has been generated from research with other modalities, and its transfer to IFT is assumed rather than proven. There is a lack of IFT specific research as compared with other modalities. Selection of a wide frequency sweeps has been considered less efficient than a smaller selective range, in that by treating with a frequency range of say 1 to 100 Hz. Effective treatment frequencies can be covered, but only for a relatively small percentage of the total treatment time. Additionally, some parts of the range might be counterproductive for the primary aims of the treatment. There are four main clinical applications for which IFT appears to be used, and these are pain relief, muscle stimulation, increased local blood flow, and reduction of edema. In addition, claims are made for its role in stimulating healing and repair. As IFT acts primarily on the nerves tissue, the strongest effects are likely to be those which are direct result of such stimulation, that is pain relief and muscle stimulation. The other effects are more likely to be secondary consequences of these. Now, what should be the treatment parameters for IFT? Stimulation can be applied using pad electrode and sponge covers. Through electroconductive gel is an effective alternative. Sponges should be thoroughly wet to ensure even current distribution. Self-adhesive pad electrodes are also available and make the IFT application easier in the view of many practitioners. The suction electrode application method has been in use for several years, and it is useful especially for larger body areas such as shoulder girdle, trunk, hip, knee. It does not appear to provide any therapeutic advantage over pad electrodes. Whichever electrode system is employed, electrode positioning should ensure adequate coverage of the area for stimulation. Using larger electrodes will minimize patient discomfort, while small, closely spaced electrode increases the risk of superficial tissue irritation and possible damage or skin burn. The bipolar application method is perfectly acceptable, and there is no physiological difference in treatment outcome, despite several anecdotal stories to contrary. Recent research evidence supports the benefit of two-pole application. Thank you.